Hi guys, welcome to episode 52 for Workers and Resources Software Republic, the Sputnik Challenge. This is going to be an exciting episode because I get to talk about what's in the next update for Workers and Resources. What are all the research going on? What is waste management and how it's being implemented, stuff like that. And I've prepared a bit for that. But before that, I would like to do a little bit of maintenance. And I want to plan some stuff so all our construction offices are busy, and we also need to import some people. Let's do that first because we can still this year. We have 200, so we can import 60 people. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here 6. Okay, excellent. Then our power lines here are done. So we can stop importing power because we have a connection again. So you can stop doing the import thing. Thank you. And you can start exporting again. 40, 40, 50, I believe. I was 40. I don't know. I am doing this with dollars because I don't know what kind of license we are going to have to buy. I'm not sure yet. So yeah. And then, oh yeah. Also, what I needed to do is these are not assigned because nothing's being done here. Let's do that. Okay, I forgot that the other day. And then, what else? Yeah, what I wanted to do is to create an electronics area here, which I already said last episode was my plan. So that's what I'm going to do. And after that, we are going to have a pretty long bit about the next update. Maybe I can prioritize you a bit so that you get done, because there's going to be a lot of construction going on here, I believe. F1. Because we need our electronical components to start building, because we need 824 tons of them. So that's a task in itself. And for that, we are going to create a chemical plastic factory. First of all, you. And I've kind of thought about this in theory. Turn you around. Yeah, put you here. And I have to remind myself to not... a little bit more space. Well, because we have room here, right? The chemicals, I wanted you. And turn you around, put you like so. A little bit here, fine by me. Okay, then we need the storage, and because this is we're going to have a helicopter construction areas, construction offices, and here we are creating the helicopters, and we're going to have landing spots and stuff, so I thought it would be nice to have the aviation fuel storage, which also has a good, I think, 500 tons, which is, I think, quite nice. So, how about something like this? We need a pump. You. You're you. So. Yeah. Have an underline or above line. No, I don't want to do this. Oh, you? You're too close. You're too close. Okay. And it's a good thing I can remove you. And you as well. I can. Where is the storage? You. Turn you around. I think maybe if I do it above ground, that's also nice. Probably. So, I have a storage near you. Oh, this is pretty nice, I think. Okay. Now you are going You're going up. No. Can I? If I put you like so, or maybe even here. EE. Okay, have a nice connection here. Remove fuel. And then go like so. Always the same, this kind of thing. Okay, so how are you doing? And where are my factory connections? Can I connect anything? It seems like. Are you pretty? Yeah, I like this better than below ground, I think. Underground. Okay. You can. Okay. Then we need a big storage. And I was looking through the storages because we have a lot, and if I have to do this on while I'm recording, that takes ages. And I picked this one because it has a lot of connections, and we can get some helicopter pads attached to it. I am leaving some space here because I want to have some. Is this enough space? Yeah, because I want to have some forklifts there. Now, then we are going to need the electrical components and the mechanical components and what was here. So, I want a big electrical components factory. 200 people working there. And that's why we need people, because we are going to be so understaffed. And 6 tons of electronics, 2.5. I think this would be okay. 85. 4.2. Would this be enough? Well, otherwise we're going to import the rest. Oh, wait a minute. What do I only need mechanical consumption. Mechanical components and plastics. Okay. It puts you like so, I think. Okay, here, and then the mechanical components is something. Which one do I want? A tiny one, this one, because we don't need these for the monument. I don't know where I'm going to want this. Let's build you first. I kind of see. Because electrical components, what do you need? Plastics, steel and chemicals. Okay. So plastics and chemicals you can get from the storage area. I don't want you to go. If I put you in between, that's an idea. Maybe something like this. Wait a minute, get rid of you. Yeah. If I try it like so, and then I need this factory connection here. You are already accessing. Okay. And then the mechanical components, where are you again? You? What do you need again? Only need steel. So in theory, I can put you here, I think. Or would you like so? I like this more. Yeah. I'm looking. Can I connect all the footpaths? How would the road connect? Things like this. I'm going to do it like so. And we need our forklift connections. Like, go like that. You're connected, you're connected, you're connected. Okay. Then we need the roads things. Forklift road connection. And we are going to put you like there. Like so, and then connect you. Oh, I need an how do you call this? Compact connection here. Factory connection, compact connection. It's not really. That's close enough. Okay. And then you can go. Oh, that's nice. And here I need another one. Because I want to go. Yeah, and it. Wait a minute. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 places for helicopter pads, I hope. I hope. Okay, let's create a road first. This is such a puzzle. So. Like here. And then how many would I need of these? The 2? Maybe. Can do it differently. I need there, right? Okay, that I put you here. And maybe maybe mirror you. This one here, let's see if you will connect. Yes. Okay, and then the road's going to change. Oh, I need you as a connection. This doesn't make sense now. Sorry, I forgot about it. Again. Because now I have more space. And you can just add you here. Maybe here. Maybe start here. Yep. Add you. No. Again. And I like the mirroring thing, to be honest. Then it should be the other way around, right? Yeah. Yeah. Put you like so, and then remove you. Yes. And then go away. Mirror you. Is this alright? Closer. Okay. Then the road. The road, please. Thank you. Oh, really? Great plan with the this is fine, okay. And then we need another forklift connection because we need one not you. You. We need one here. Go away. We need one here. Here. Doesn't fit nice. So, then connect you. Oh. You don't fit. Oh, but you said you fit. because I'm going to that way. Okay, let's remove part of the this one again. Okay, connect you. Do we have all connections? No, you don't. You don't. I'm probably forgetting important parts here. I might want to have this as a connection as well. You're never going to fit, right? Probably not. I like that the piping is above the ground, but I don't like the limitations it gives you every time. So are you wanting to connect? Yeah, you do. Yeah, let's do that. That's fine, thank you. Now will you fit? Okay. I don't know if it's still pretty, but it's still there. Really. Okay. So I'm not planning the how do you say this? The helicopter pads. I think we are pretty much done here. We are going to have to start constructing everything. So you can start to construct, and the roads I need to finish some things because you're done, so now I can connect you here. Try to connect you like here. Connect you. Connect you. Connect you. Okay. Need a road thingy here. Let's see how this will connect. Road. So. Okay. Let's see if we can get our construction office to build this. So, do we want some? Yep. Build this as well. Oh, I forget the road here. Well, we can do it later. Okay. So. I messed up and where were we? I was assigning this, I believe. Assigning you, because you can also start constructing now. So at least we can start constructing. So this being done, and we are exporting stuff again, and I hope maybe you are busy a bit. No, still low priority, so you have lots of stuff to do. There's still being, I thought of following a vehicle. Like so, but I want to zoom out a bit because otherwise it creates so much noise. So kind of do it like so. Okay, I created a bit and I want to read it to you because it's way too much to remember. I can't do that. Bibble Joe created a video on what's new in the new version 0.8.9.0, which he created a video for exclusive for patrons or YouTube member. Well, I'm a patron there-ish. And I've asked, and I can talk about it here, but I won't show you. I can't show you because I'm also not a beta tester, and I'm all the information here I got from this video. So this is what I know. Please consider being a member of his channel or becoming a patron. Exciting stuff is going to happen there. and it's just a fun channel. So let's dive in. This update is huge. It's absolutely a complete game changer. And that is the understatement of the year, truly. Start with easy box height. Forget about it. Vehicle protection line and make 120k each month after year one? Nope. Knowing where resources are on the map on the start. Here are no locations of resources anymore. Because that's behind the research. Let's get rid of you. So, what can we expect? Waste management, maintenance, resources, and other stuff. In the menu, you can turn on options for waste management. You can decide only waste management or waste management and demolition of buildings. So we now have demolition too. Maintenance, we can have maintenance for vehicles and for buildings, and we can turn researches on and off. So let's first talk about waste management. Most buildings have a garbage production per worker. The technical services now also manages waste. There are various different types of waste. You have construction waste, we have metal scrap, we have aluminum scrap, we have biological waste, we have plastic waste, we have hazardous waste, and the last one, the mixed waste. Bio, hazardous and mixed waste go into a dump container. Plastic waste go into an open storage. The rest go into an aggregate storage. You can assign a drop-off location for each type of waste. There are small and big waste container stands. In the big one, in the big waste container stand, you can specify what kind of waste you can store there. And per waste type, the waste container has cute colors. There's like this copper kind of color and this aluminum kind of color. It's really nice. There are three types of waste separation buildings. All waste separation buildings have a separation efficiency based on the input material. What cannot be separated remains mixed waste. So you have a waste separation building and that exports mixed waste, which is also import. So could you put the exported mixed waste back into the import of this production? I don't know how that works. So then we have waste separation stands three times, namely general separation. Separates mixed waste into construction waste, metal scraps, aluminum, plastic or mixed waste. This has the lowest efficiency. It's between 60 and 87% efficiency. Then we can do scrap separation. Separates mixed waste into metal scrap with a 98% efficiency. Aluminum separation separates mixed waste into aluminum scrap with a 97% efficiency. Then, next step, it can go into a recycling plant. There are four types. A gravel recycling plant that you don't have to research and takes construction waste as input. You have a plastic recycling plant that takes plastic waste and produces plastic. A steel recycling plant that takes metal scrap and produces steel. And an aluminum recycling plant that takes aluminum scrap and creates aluminum. Then, finally, there are incinerators. A small and a big one that are not locked behind research. The general separation is not locked behind research. The scrap and the aluminum separation, I think, is. The efficiency is based upon the stuff you put into it and takes biological waste, fertilizer, burnable something, I couldn't read it, plastic waste, hazardous waste and other waste. They're also very good at polluting the environment. They are a whopping 60 versus 71 tons of pollution. So that's like two times a heating plant. Which is the most polluting building we have, I believe. I think they are supposed to produce power or something, but what they produce, the normal incinerators, that's unclear to me. Locked behind research are also a power generator that produces 660 megawatt hours. And we also have a heating incinerator that produces 135, I don't know what it stands for, joule, gigajoule of heat. Again, the efficiency is based on what waste you deliver, and they are also very polluting. Let me see if everything is going a little bit right. Why are you taking this dirt road? Anyway, let's continue. There is an area in the menu for scrapyards as well, but nothing clear on that yet on this point. Then finally, the landfills. There is a small and a large landfill, and a transfer for big waste container building. I think you can drop off your container with waste and it slowly fills the landfill, but on shore. I don't know how that works. Again, if you watch Bebel Joe's video, you have visuals on that, and I think that makes it more clear than this. What we also have, we have demolition offices, so we can demolish building and reuse the materials. Isn't that so cool? A small one, a large one, and maybe a helicopter demolition office. It said helicopter demolition office, but I was not sure if that's really going to be the case. At this time, it's still unstable, and well, I haven't been able to watch a lot of that. So at this point, not more to say about that. Then, maintenance. Each building and vehicle has a lifespan. There are now large and small vehicle repair stations. The large one has 80 workers that can repair vehicles. These stations work in a working range and have the same input material as an airline production line uses. They create mixed waste. I think it works that you can set at what percentage you want vehicles to go to maintenance. This station has a waiting queue for vehicles depending on the number of workers. So that's wrong. It doesn't have a waiting queue depending on the number of workers. The queue gets more empty quicker depending on the number of workers is what I mean here. So this in essence mean that end stations will have to deal with vehicles that are in maintenance. Per vehicle you can see how many kilometers it has driven and how old it is. You can also set the repair needs and view the status of the repair needs per vehicle. Next, we have an automatic vehicle replacement. You can replace vehicles from the depot, from a vehicle storage, or purchase new based on its age and wear and tear. This goes for all vehicles, helicopters, trains, ships, cars, you name it. Most buildings have a lifespan now and also a lifespan for the vehicles who operate inside these buildings. I've seen buildings that have a lifespan like 10 years or like 15 years. Next to that, buildings have a percentage of wear and tear. I think it's probably going to be construction offices that will take care of maintenance. BBTO thinks so too, but nothing clear on that yet. So, and then for a big one, research. There are different types of research in the three buildings, and I'm going to name a lot. So, here it goes. In the three buildings, I mean, we have three kind of universities. We have a medical university, we have a technical university, and we have a headquarters of the Communist Party. We only have large universities at this point, no small ones yet. So, the medical university, we can research virology, new discipline to viruses and vaccinations against them, preventative medicine, reduced departures of ambulances, enlightenment for the hardening, which is get residents to be more sustainable to cold. I'm thinking DLC here. Vitamins, make citizens more resistant to pollutions. We need that here. Increase, decrease natality, which I think is a way to control birth rate. Alcohol standards, which is, I think, less negative affection of alcohol to citizens' health. Then, in a technical university, we can research engineering, chemistry, pollution, phone tapping, forest study. Could it be sustainable forest, hopefully? Broadcasting, study on concrete, fuel study, bitumen study, metallurgy study, faculty of geology, airports, Capital of Nuclear Science, Gas Power Plant, Fertilizing. That was it for the technical universe. Is that enough? No, because we also have a headquarters of the Community Party where we can research fire prevention basis research, party members ranking, air traffic study, tourism study, logistic optimization, container standards. And what I'm saying now is just the top tier research. There's going to be a research tree, but at the time of Weeble Joe's video that was being made, 3 hours later it was done, he told me. Always nice how that works out, but it's up to 5 to 6 levels deep. So what I'm talking about is not one research, like pollution is not one research, probably going to be several research areas. I also saw that the pollution monitor is now behind research. So what's behind the research that I know of and what I've been able to doctor out of the video of Weeble Joe? Well, doctor, he went on it. So prefab panels, taxiways, runways, the airport control tower. So you need that in order for airplanes to lift off. Cableways, distribution offices. We can now only build a maximum of 5 3 distribution offices and that's it. So 5 times 3 vehicles is 15 vehicles you can use in your distribution offices at max before you need to research. Train distribution office, container loading unloading facilities, a gas power plant, solar power plant, windmills, the 18 megawatt high voltage wire, you have to research. Most of the waste separation buildings, most of the big residential buildings, I saw any building that's bigger than 177 people, that's the one which was 95% lower than 95% building quality. There's a separate research. Let me rephrase it. This is not clear. You need to research buildings that have prefab panels and you need to research buildings that have a higher quality than 95%, I think. The last one, I think. And all residential buildings now have a passenger capacity. That probably is a typo. So, here it comes. Radio station is locked, TV station are locked, so no easy or easy-ish control of your I'm looking for words, of your loyalty. Hospital helicopters, fire station helicopters, secret police is behind the research, pollution monitor station, I already said that, big tourism hotels, big monuments. Synthetic fertilizer factory is behind research, more on that later. The oil refinery, chemical plant, the plastics factory, the bauxite mine, wax, a lot of bauxite related, all behind research. Steel mill, behind research. All nuclear advanced industry, electronics, electrical components, the vehicle production line. Mechanical components, the train production line, the dry dock, the airplane production line. I think I should have started with buildings that are not behind research, to be honest, but I didn't. So, this is about the waste and the research and the vehicle, the aging of vehicles, but there are further things. There are new types of high and low voltage switches and also a switch that can have priority for all input and output connections. And this one I personally find very nice. There is a variety of new bushes and trees. A plant brush too. That look like you can also brush grass. Yes, that would be so cool. Farm fields now have a fertility percentage and a nutrient level. You can deliver fertilizer at the field which you can store at the farm. Either liquid fertilizer or solid fertilizer. I don't know if fields can have a pipeline connection to deliver the liquefied fertilizer, but we'll have to see. You can set a minimum fertility level at the farm, so have specific farms for the most unfertile fields, and what that is do, I don't know. You can store a bunch of stuff now at the fields, like 7 or 8 different kinds of stuff that I have no idea what it is, and I couldn't see. It seems like the fields are going to be used for more things, like maybe pastures or something? I don't know. Then there is a synthetic fertilizer factory that takes chemicals and water and creates liquid fertilizer. Or a composting plant that creates solid fertilizer and consumes biological waste and chemicals. We have finally percentages. All status bar now have percentages, so no guessing anymore how far your construction is going or what your actual health is based on that graph. And save the best for last. There is going to be foreign pipeline connections. Yes, baby. Yes, and it also requires, of course, research. And there's separate research for Soviet pipeline connections and for Western pipeline connections. I am so excited for this release. There is so much on it. And I, just as a reminder, I don't have early access of this game. I just base it off of Bibble Joe's video with his permission. If you want a link to the video, don't ask me, but become a patron or a YouTube member at Bibble Joe's. So let's go further on the let's play, because my ventilator has been working overtime. And so maybe I can kind of relax him a bit. I don't know if stuff went wrong here. It seems quite all right. We're still quite happy. I'm very excited for the... I've said it a gazillion times now. So, how far are we in? I don't know. We are 40 minutes in. Yeah, I don't think I can do a lot anymore. Look, this is going to go to the next phase. And we are building stuff. Yes, see, this... I don't think this is going to be pretty, but... Let's see how this goes. So yeah, this was for this episode, I guess. Let's remove the road here, because we don't need you anymore. Let's remove some of these temporary roads. You go away. You go away as well. Yep. You can go away. And also the one I created here. You can go. Because I really don't want you to use this road, actually. And why were you just entering the road when I wanted to get rid of you? I forgot to set you on. Come on, hurry up. Because then I can't conclude the episode. Yes, be polite. Thank you. Go. Yes. That was a close call. Okay, are you excited for the new episode? If you have questions, please leave a comment. I don't know if I can answer them, or otherwise I can kind of see if Bibble Joe is willing to answer. I don't know. Thank you very much for watching. It's the 16th of June. Bye bye.